Well, good morning again, boys and girls. It's Uncle Aaron, and thanks for watching today's video. Today, we're going to get started with our action memory verse, followed by the Bible story time, and then we'll finish with our Bible Zone praise song. Are you ready to get started? Okay, here we go. Okay, boys and girls, it's time for our action memory verse. Our action memory verse comes from the book of Psalms, chapter 33, verse 4, and it says, "For the word of the Lord is right and true. He is faithful in all he does." So this verse is telling us that the word of the Lord, the Bible, everything that God says in the Bible is right and it's true. If we think we know better or other people think they know better than God, they're wrong. The word of the Lord, God's word, the Bible, is right and true. And then it says, he is faithful. That means he's trustworthy. He always keeps his promises. God is faithful in all he does, all right? So let's do it now with some actions. Are you ready? Okay. Psalms chapter 33, verse 4. Here we go with the actions. For the word of the Lord, I'm going to make this like a Bible. For the word of the Lord is right and true. He is faithful in all he does. Let's do it one more time. Psalms chapter 33, verse 4. For the word of the Lord is right and true. He is faithful in all he does. Last week's video was called Eli's Sons Disobeyed God. Let's see what happens in this week's video.
Paul, a missionary and follower of Jesus, wrote a letter to the church in Ephesus. Paul taught the believers that God takes sin seriously.
First, Paul explained that people are different before they trust in Jesus and after they trust in Jesus. Paul wrote, "Before you knew Jesus, you were dead in your sins. You used to live like the world, like those who choose to disobey God. We all lived like that, doing whatever felt right to us."
Sin has consequences. The Bible says the fair punishment for sin is death. Everyone faces physical death, but people who do not trust in Jesus face spiritual death too. They are separated from God forever. This is very sad news.
But God's plan for people is good news. Paul wrote about this good news. "But God, who is full of mercy because of his great love that he had for us, made us alive with Christ. We were spiritually dead, and then he gave us life. You were saved by grace." This means that everyone who trusts in Jesus will have spiritual life, life with God forever.
Then Paul explained what else God has done for everyone who trusts in Jesus. God raised us up with Christ and gave us a seat with him in the heavens. This way, he can show us grace and kindness, both now and for all time.
Paul wrote, "For you are saved by grace, through faith. And this is not from yourselves. It is God's gift, not from works, so that no one can boast. We are God's masterpiece, created in Christ Jesus to do the good works God has prepared for us to do."
God takes sin seriously. People deserve to die for their sins, but God loves us and sent his son, Jesus, to defeat death by dying on the cross for our sins and rising from the dead. Everyone who trusts in Jesus has eternal life.
So boys and girls, we learned in that video that God takes sin very seriously. Now, as a reminder, sin is anything that we do, anything that we say, or even anything that we think that is against God. And when we sin, we're breaking God's heart and we're damaging our relationship with him and with other people. Sometimes we might think that, well, everybody sins, so it's not that big of a deal. Or, didn't really bother anybody, so it doesn't matter. Or we might think that we're so used to sin and we see it all around us all the time, we might not think it's that big of a deal. But it is a big deal, boys and girls. I want to let you know, it's a huge deal. And sin separates us from God. And sin is the reason that we have so much brokenness and pain and suffering in our world. So sin is very, very serious, and it needs to be punished. We need to also understand that God is perfect. That means He has never sinned. He is good and perfect all the time. His thoughts, His actions, His words are all perfect. And when He made us to have relationship with Him. And He didn't want us to be sinning and doing bad things that go against Him and damage our relationship with Him. So when we sin, we mess that all up. And God does not want things to be that way. So when we sin, it hurts us. Even if we don't realize it, it hurts us, it hurts other people, and it hurts God most of all. So this is all kind of bad news, right? Like, you're hearing that sin is such a bad thing, and God is very upset when we sin, and all of our sin separates us from God. That's really bad news. But the good news is this, is that God knew things would be this way, and so He had a plan to make things right again. The truth is that none of us can ever be good enough to make up for our sins. We just can't do it. It doesn't mean that we shouldn't try to be good and do the right things, but by doing the right thing, it's not like we can fix things between us and God. It's not like we can earn our way into heaven or fix our relationship with God. We can't do it. But the good news is that God sent Jesus, and Jesus took the punishment that we deserve for the sins that we've done. We deserve to be punished, but Jesus took that punishment. So when we trust in Him and follow Him, we can be forgiven of our sins, and our relationship with God can be fixed forever. Now, you might ask the question, are some sins worse than other sins? Well, here's what I want to say first, which is really important to understand. All sins separate us from God, and all sins need to be punished. So let's get that out of the way. That's just true. Now, are there some sins that cause more damage than other sins? Yes, I would say absolutely. So if I have a bad thought about somebody and I say something mean to somebody, that's really bad. But there are some actions and some sins that do a lot more damage. So for example, if I have a bad thought about somebody and say, oh, I really don't like that person, and you know, they're stupid, which is really mean, but that's also a sin. If I have that thought, that is a sin and that upsets God, but what would be even greater sin is if I actually said that to Him or if I hurt them in some way. So some sins have worse results than other sins. It leads to more damage, but the truth is that all sins need to be punished, and all of them are very upsetting to God. I'd like to close with this question. Why do you think that living for God is better than living in sin? Boys and girls, it's time for our Bible Zone praise song. The song that we're going to do today is called How Far Love Goes. And just like we've been talking before, this song is telling us that Jesus came to earth to take the punishment for our sin that we deserved. And so this song is reminding us that God didn't just tell us that He loved us, He showed us by sending Jesus to fix things so that when we trust and follow Him, our relationship with Him can be sorted out. So let's think about that and let's celebrate as we sing How Far Love Goes.
For all who are broken and lost, You
All right, boys and girls, we're going to close in a prayer, but before we do that, I want to remind you, if you have any questions at all about anything we talked about today or anything you saw in the video, you can email me at the email address below, but make sure you get mom or dad's permission first. All right, let's close our eyes so we don't get distracted. We're going to pray to God. Let's pray. Dear God, I thank you for how much you love us, and I thank you that even though we sometimes sin, you've made a way for us to be forgiven. God, I pray that because we've been forgiven when we trust and follow you as our Savior, I pray that we wouldn't just continue to sin. We would understand that it hurts us, it hurts other people, but most of all, it hurts you. So help us to obey you and to be quick to ask for forgiveness, but to also celebrate the fact that you love us so much, you made a way for us to be forgiven. And so, God, I pray that we would follow after you and want to do what's right and want to obey you, because the rules you put in place are there to protect us, not to take away fun. You want us to be protected and to be safe. So help us to understand all of that. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Boys and girls, thank you so much for watching today's video. And remember, God sent his son Jesus to save us from our sins forever. I'll see you next week.